Okay, everybody, welcome back. I've been receiving numerous emails and private messages and questions regarding what happened to the video where I was showcasing revision 3.3. Now, I ended up having to delete that video because the hacker has changed the revision. It's still 3.3, but he went and added more features to it than what were previously mentioned. In the original video, I talked about how there were only three items that have been changed. Now, let me count here. What happened to it? There it is, all right. Now, there are 8 items that have been changed between 3.1 and this new 3.3. Another reason behind the change is because there were some comments and some concerns about how only changing three items was not really worth anyone's time in downloading and trying out and playing a new revision. They might as well just keep playing 3.1. So I can only assume the hacker took that into account and decided to go ahead and make these additional five changes to what were originally just the three. So initially, the three original changes were the revision text was changed from 3.1 to 3.3. At the top of the screen on the character select, it would say, choose your character, and it was changed to You Will Die Immortal, and the walk cycles had been changed. Those were the three changes on the original 3.3 version that I made the previous video on. Now, there were some complaints that those three changes weren't big enough to warrant a whole new revision. So the hacker went ahead and made five new changes. So you have those three that are still there. Then you also have the Sub-Zero's fatality when he does forward down high kick, where people can sit there and do that for infinity. That has been, the timer has been taken away from that. So basically what that means is you press forward down high kick and you have to do the rest of the fatality, or the timer runs out and it takes you, you know, to the next match. So no more infinite freeze for Sub-Zero on the first part of his fatality is just the easier way to say that. So that was removed. The fatality time has been increased. It's not infinite fatality time like the Challenger hack, but it went from, I believe it went from 3 seconds to 6 seconds. So he almost doubled. I believe it's actually 3 seconds to 5.5. So he wrote the frames down, told me the frames, but I didn't write I just wrote down that the fatality time has been increased. So you have, it went from 3 seconds to 5.5. So you have an extra 2.5 seconds to do your fatality. So that was increased. Let's see here. GORO'S LAIR has been changed from the no name. I have a video talking about and showcasing the glitch that you can perform on Jade, that when you start a new game, the first stage you play on is GORO'S LAIR. But when you do that, it says no name at the bottom of the screen for the stage you're on. It'll say no name. Well, it's been changed now to say GORO'S LAIR. So it says GORO'S LAIR now. And then also, GORO'S LAIR has been added into the cycle for the stages. When you play the game and you get to the Pit 2, the next stage after the Pit 2 is now GORO'S LAIR. So previously you were only able to fight on GORO'S LAIR when you were playing against the secret characters. Well, now GORO'S LAIR shows up in the normal rotation of the stages. So you can play on GORO'S LAIR after the Pit 2 now. And pardon me, and also, there's a hidden, I don't want to say hidden, but there's a rare game over screen on Mortal Kombat 2. Just like Mortal Kombat 1, every so often you'll have a different game over screen. For instance, Mortal Kombat 1 shows the pit and the camera pans down, and as it goes down, it shows the bodies on the spikes and everything. There's a rare game over screen on Mortal Kombat 2 also, where it says game over in front of GORO'S LAIR, and it has the Roman numeral 3 hinting at Mortal Kombat 3, for those of you who haven't seen it. Well, it's been changed now, so that appears every time the game over screen comes up, you get that secret or that rare game over screen. So that's there every time. So those are the 8 changes. I'm being a little long-winded here, so thanks for bearing with me, but those are the 8 changes. So the revision text says 3.3, You Will Die Immortal. The walk cycles have been fixed. The Sub-Zero's fatality on the first part of a fatality is no longer infinite time. The fatality time has been increased. GORO'S LAIR, it says GORO'S LAIR now instead of no name. The GORO'S LAIR has been added to the cycle of stages and the game over screen, the rare game over screen. So anyway, there we go. long-winded there, but I'll do some gameplay here so you can see some of the details I've been talking about. You can see there, you will die mortal. Let's go ahead and do two players. No more infinite ice. And what I mentioned before about walk cycles is that originally when you tap the joystick, see, I'm just tapping the joystick back and forth. Originally they would do an entire step backwards or step forwards. Well, now it's just a little foot shuffle, so it makes the game a little bit more responsive when you're trying to do special moves and recover and things like that. So I'll show you the increased fatality time here. Damn it, I don't know what I'm doing here. You got a couple extra seconds there on the fatality time. Okay, so I actually lied to you. Goro's Lair is after Khan's Arena here. Not the Pit 2. Stage should say GORO'S LAIR at the bottom. There you go. Okay, now, the timer go down here, now I'll lose and you'll see the game over screen. There you go. So hopefully, if any of you guys are interested in playing the game, you can. I'll give you the download link in the video description below, and just download it and put it in your ROMs folder and have a go, or burn yourself a copy, or whatever you want to do.